Всем привет! Welcome back to Ari Russian. In our daily life, we receive a lot of invitations for many activities such as family gatherings or meeting with good friends and so on. But sometimes you really can't accept someone's invitation or suggestion and you have to refuse it. Or when someone gives you an advice but you don't like it, you will say no. Today, I will introduce the common ways of saying no in Russian. But before we will start, I'd like to remind you to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notifications so that you will not miss my next videos. Are you ready? Let's begin! The first word I'm going to tell you about is, of course, the word нет. Нет. That means no. I think it's one of the first words people usually face with when they start to learn Russian. I think it's a very simple word to say no, and it can be remembered easily. But you need to keep in mind is that using нет alone sometimes sounds a bit blunt, so we often add something after it, depending on the situation, if we want to smooth this effect and be more polite. For example, in some situations we can add спасибо, thanks, or не надо, no need, or some more information to extend and clarify our no. For example, I came by my friend's house and my friend suggested me to drink some coffee. Хочешь кофе? I already drank a cup of coffee in the morning and I usually drink only one cup a day, so I can refuse politely and say нет, спасибо. Я уже пила кофе сегодня. Хочешь кофе? Do you want a cup of coffee? Нет, спасибо. Я уже пила кофе сегодня. No, thanks. I already drank coffee today. There are also some informal ways to say нет that you may hear in everyday conversations. Those are не and неа. They are similar to nope and used very often when we are talking to our friends. Like in such situation, you and your friend are choosing movie for tonight. Your suggestion is to watch a detective movie, but your friend prefers to watch a comedy today. Давай посмотрим детектив сегодня. Не, не хочу. Давай лучше посмотрим комедию. Давай посмотрим детектив сегодня. Let's see the detective today. Нет, не хочу. Давай лучше посмотрим комедию. No, I don't want to. Let's see a comedy. And if you forgot how to use давай or давайте in Russian language, or you'd like to know more about it, you can check one of my previous videos where I'm telling about this. I'll leave the link in the description box for you. There is also a little bit confusing phrase in Russian that at first sight includes a positive and a negative answer at one time. Да, нет. You know that the first part, да, means yes, but the second part means no. So what does it mean? The other person agrees or disagrees with you. Particle да is not only used to express an agreement. It often helps us to emphasize something or to express an emotion, or in the beginning of the sentence it's sometimes used to express thinking process to fill in the time we spent to think on the answer. When we answer да, нет, it seems like we were deciding how to answer and after all leaned more to a negative answer. Depending on the situation, this expression can mean something like well, no, or actually no, or not really. For example, when I'm in the store and buying a cake for the first time, I usually ask for advice. I prefer some kind of fruit cake, which is light and not so sweet. And when I found something I might like, I can ask a seller about it. Скажите, пожалуйста, этот торт очень сладкий? Да нет, не очень. Скажите, пожалуйста, этот торт очень сладкий? Tell me please, is this cake very sweet? Да нет, не очень. No, not really. One more tricky phrase is да нет, наверное. The beginning of this phrase is similar to the previous one, so we can translate the beginning as well, no, and plus наверное, that means maybe. And as a result, we have, well, maybe no. Saying this phrase, the person is refusing, but at the same time, he or she doubts a lot. If someone answered you, да нет, наверное, it means that the person is not sure in his answer, so you still have an opportunity to convince him and maybe change his mind, like in this situation. Пойдешь с нами кататься на роликах? Да нет, наверное. Ну пойдем, будет весело. Пойдешь с нами кататься на роликах? Will you go rollerblading with us? Да нет, наверное. Well, maybe no. Ну пойдем, будет весело. Let's go, it will be fun. And the last phrase is конечно нет. Конечно translates as of course. So the meaning of this phrase is of course not. It's a way to express a strong no. For example, the kids were playing soccer in the yard and accidentally broke the window in the store nearby. The owner is asking one of the kids, "Это ты разбил окно?" And the child answers on it, "Конечно нет, я здесь вообще ни при чем." Это ты разбил окно? Was this you who broke the window? Конечно нет, я здесь вообще ни при чем. Of course not, I have nothing to do with it. Okay, that's it for today's video. Today I introduced the ways of saying no in Russian. I hope this video was useful for you. If you liked it, you can subscribe to my channel and share this video with all your friends who want to learn Russian. See you next time. Пока-пока.